Hiya, people! Hi! How are you all? Hi, guys! Welcome! Hi, Brittany, Iselina, and Ava, and Abby, and Barb, and Dee Dee, and Colouring Park, and Alicia. Hello. Are you here?
Hi.
Hi. Miranda, and Shalene, and Joey, and Michelle. Hello! Pat, gee, that was quick, Pat. Hi. Kelly and Rosemary and, who would you know? I just saw someone else's name then. No, that's it. Is that it? I forgot everyone? So far, so good. Hi. Did I say Michelle? I did say Michelle. So, check it. I finished my card. I made it 3D, so I kind of lifted up the wings a bit, so it casts a bit of a shadow, and it's a card, so I can write something in there and send it off to someone. How cute did she come out, hey? This was Michelle Keller's image that I did yesterday. Pretty cute. Yeah. Am I really that far behind? I have the aircon on today, so I have a little bit of air noise. I hope it's not too much. If it is, we can turn it off too. So, and then, for the end of the stream, I coloured this cutie pie. And I was just about to colour the wings before we left. And I just finished it off colouring it with the Calero Fine Tech paints. I used the deep purple and whatever colour this is, which I'm not sure what it is, to do the wings. And then I used some Wink of Stella on the pink flower here. And I used the stickles for the rest of it. I used the pink, glam pink, and some palm leaf. And I used for the outside part silver. For all of those little spots on the outside there. But look how shiny her wings are. Can you guys see that in the camera? Shining. I'll put some on her eyes too. Look, can you see the little sparklies in her eyes? She came up so cute. So that was the Colour in Chicks, a little fairy. After me, Heather CBC is colouring the other Colour in Chicks image. So you'll see that. Hi Mary, hi Angela, hi Sarah, welcome guys. I ended up doing the rest of it off stream, Pat, because... You know, I wanted to cut it out and that takes time. But yeah, it's got glitter on her too. She came out really cute. The Ingo Fay. Hi, anyone I've missed? Welcome. Dee Dee. Did I see you before? I don't know. The one that I'm doing for my color along is, yes, where is it? This lady is, oh, that's my newest one. I haven't finished it yet. But this one, yes, this one from Yana is a month, the whole month. So this is on Fridays. From Yana Prosperina. So yeah. I did. Good to know, Pat. Hi, Shadow. Yes, she's a rat bag. She came out 10 minutes before I started, and then she's just sitting at the door meowing at me. Like, you need to do something for me. Who knows what that is. Anyway, very cute, very cute. So today, I've got the lovely Dawn Davidson. Nani, what's the matter with you? What are you doing? Nani, saying hello too. She's sitting on the arm of the chair. All I did with Sarah was I cut out the image. It was just on a piece of paper like this, so I cut it all around it. And I just pulled the wings up, just sort of squished them up a little bit, and then stuck it on the card to make it look like that. So the whole image has just been stuck down with glue. See? On my card. That's it. So I just bent the wings up like that. And then went. This is pretty crappy glue, but I was quickly sort of doing it to show. And that's it. And then just, it's on a card. So I just had a bit of red card that I liked. Popped it on there. So that's all I did. It's actually not centered now. See what I've done? I can't look at it. I had to play around with a couple of mediums for today. I was thinking about using Copic, but I always use Copic. So I thought we'd try some watercolor. So these are just Cotman watercolors. They come out all right on this paper. This is the Bristol Smooth Vellum, Bristol Vellum Surface, I should say, not smooth, vellum. Kathy. So, I decided to have a play. This one here was the Tombow, so I think I'm going to use Tombows today. I think that came out really awesome, and it didn't crinkle. This was ink tense. I didn't like how that worked. And the Cotman came out a little bit weird looking. I think we're going to use Tombows, because they came out awesome. But using them as watercolour. What are you two doing? Nani, what are you doing? I'm being attacked. Oh, yogurt lid. I knew you'd find it, Missy. I had a yogurt and I dropped the lid. I couldn't find it anywhere, and I knew that Nani would find it, and she did. So I'm going to try some Tombows. So you can use a Tombows like texters, markers. We call them texters here. That was an Australian thing. Markers. Or I found that on some papers you can use them like watercolors. So that's what I'm going to do. Because I like them like that. They're really bright. And, yeah. No worries, Sarah. So, yeah, we're going to play with those. Let's do it. Shall we? I got my drink. And I got my swatch chart over here. With my Tombow list on it. No, oh, now she's telling you off because you put her out. Yep. So I've got all of the Tombows here. I did replace a couple of them to get the whole... Hello, Shadow. Really? Oh. What? So we're going to do those today. Pat. So, welcome. For those that don't know you, my name's Belinda. And today we're continuing on with our Colorathon for February. We have had some awesome images already. Later today, we've got still to come Nathaniel Wake with Tonya. Tonya, I don't know if I'm saying it right. We've still got Heather, who's doing the other Color and Chicks image. We have Emily doing Emily's own image. We've got CB doing... CB is CB's craft and... anyway, she's doing Yana later. We've also got Colouring F, who's doing Christine Caran. And we've also got Colouring with Vicky, who's doing a Monya image. So we've still got a couple more images that... artists that are yet to be represented. So there you go. Good fun. Is the air conditioner too loud, guys? Or should I turn it off? She does. She's a brat. A brat. So I learned a few things watching some streams while I was flat on my back last night with a very, very sore back. Thanks, Dee Dee. And I learned that apparently I've been saying Nell's name wrong. It's Naleke. Naleke? And I've been calling her Nalek. So how weird is that? How embarrassing. I'm so sorry, Nell. I also heard about some interesting bodily functions in Heather's stream, which was quite interesting and funny. We've had a great few days. Really enjoyed myself. The streamers have been awesome. We've had heaps of fun. Everybody's been polite and everybody's been getting along really well. And I'm super impressed. It was bad. Lisa's live stream was a show. She's a performer at heart for sure. That one. Yeah, this one's not quite as squeaky as my other one. I only saw the start of it, but her and her tech support looked like they were a bit of a hoot, so I'll have to go back and watch that one. And I completely miss Sammy, but I'll go back and have a look. I know that she would have done something amazing, as she always does. So we've had quite a few streamers and we've still got quite a few to go. So that's cool too. I don't have the schedule up. Let me find it again. I don't know why it got closed. For those that are wanting to know what's next or haven't been watching, okay, here it is. Oh, good, Rosemary. Yes, Sarah, they were both, awesome. Okay. That was the Colorathon spreadsheet, the list of streamers. And there's also a few other surprises that have been going on. If you've been going along to all the streams already, you'll know that of what's been happening. We've got a free image from Nathaniel Wake. Now, Nathaniel Wake, this is the free image. which is a male fairy, which I actually chose as the free image. He gave me a choice of which one I wanted to have for the streams. And that's the one I picked because we don't have a lot of male fairies. But his Etsy store has just been reopened. He's had it for a while, but he's just revamped things. And he's added heaps of images and heaps that were actually on special. So he's done quite a few fairy images for the event. So go check them out. They're already priced down in the shop. He will be changing the prices after the event, so they may go back up again after. So go check them out because he's put a lot of effort in. And he also put a lot of effort into fixing a few images up and cleaning some things up and making a really big effort to help help us as colorists as well. So go check him out. He's just put up a whole heap of dragons in the last day, and they're amazing. So go check those out too. He's kind of like a silent partner in this event. I'm his liaison, and I'm really quite honored to be that for him. And I just want to make sure that everybody checks him out as well, because he's done a lot as well. And especially with the free image, which I've just posted up there. Okay. Hi, Patty. Were you asking about the Pablo swatching thing? Because this is my Pablo swatch chart. Have you seen it? Here it is. This is my flip book. And also I've done Pablo coloured mixes on my Patreon too. But anyway, I just remember that when you popped in. The other free image we have is by Emily Illustrator, who has also put a lot of effort in, decided to help out with streaming, and asked if she could join in on the images as well. So both a streamer and an artist. Emily has given her free fairy image as well. So I've got that here. Also, all of these links are in the description below, so make sure you grab them as well. And Emily's just posted another new image up in her shop. It looked like a unicorn from what I could see. I just saw it out of the corner of my eye. So she's got lots going on in her Etsy store too. Been taking naps, miss Sammy's. Oh, I miss Sammy's too. I fell asleep. You know what? Lisa came on and I said hello and that was it. I don't remember anything else. It's gone. So, yeah. Very exciting. Today I have, Shelley has purchased Dawn Davidson image, so I'm giving away today for my giveaway either this one or the other one today, so whichever one you decide to choose. And I don't have the other one because I wasn't that organized. Sorry, but there's two you can choose from of Dawn's for today. And also I'll be doing the same giveaways that have been sort of going on through all of the streams. So if you haven't gotten the Lisa image or the what's the other one? Genovia art one, then you can have a chance to win that today as well. So I will try to pop them up in a little bit to show you. Maybe I'll try to do it now. Shall I try it now? Yeah, no. I'll do it in a minute. I'll get my phone out and do it. That's the idea of them, is to get you to see all the artists out there and to expose them to you, new people, and also so you can check out some of the other streamers. So let me go and get these images, giveaway images. So there was this one, Lisa. And this one by Genovia Art. So they're the ones that we'll be doing in the giveaway. Hi, Kenny. Oh, thanks for coming in. Hi, Rochelle. Welcome. All right, so shall we go? Shall I color? Oh, if you want a list of all of the if you want a list of all of the artists, it's in the description below. However, I did pop it in a document if you'd like to check that out as well. Somewhere. This one? If you want to check out all the artists and their links, it's there as well. Okay, I think I'm ready to start. I don't know. Your card is full. No, I can imagine. I know. Uh-oh, Kenny's got hiccups. Hi, Coloring Park, welcome. Did I see you before? Maybe I did. Oh, well, you got two hellos. Let's do some coloring. What am I going to do first? Do I do skin first or background first? Let's see if we can work out what kind of skin colors to use with these. My biggest problem is I don't know how many layers I'm going to be able to do. I did not test that. So maybe we'll just do like an all over skin color. And then maybe add shadows after. I don't know. It's all new. I get them a lot too, Kenny. Oh, hi, Bo. You have been lucky. All right. Yeah, Alicia's here. She's going to write them down. I have, she's written down the last two images in the colors and everything that I used. So we'll try and post them on Patreon for patrons later on too, if you're interested in that. But obviously with the Art and Fly markers, we don't have any color comparisons for those yet. So it might take us a while to go through those, but, they will come. They will come. Oh, they want to give medicine for everything, don't they? Hi, Lulu. What? It's like, why don't they just want to cover, they don't want to, like, they want to fix the symptoms, but they don't want to fix the problem. I'm going to try some saddle brown first. Coming into all of the shadow areas. Oh, they're really nice on this paper. I'm using the Strathmore Bristol Vellum. Because I ran out of the other one I was using. Still waiting for it. Well, we might do the light source coming from, like, this direction, maybe. Because most of those shadows kind of suggest that anyway. So we'll put a little bit of a shadow under this side of our flower. bit of a shadow around that little nose. Some behind the hair. And let's go down here. Definitely need a shadow under this piece of hair because that would be overshadowing that area. Bit of a shadow over here. Okay. Oh, I smudged it. Oops. I don't really know what the difference is. Patty? I mean, there's lots of different regular types of cardstock. I usually try to use a brand because people always ask me what I'm using, and if I just say normal cardstock that I got from a shop here in Australia, it's really hard for people to find. So, generally, it's probably the only reason I don't use it. I do have... this is a 910. What's 910? Opal. I don't know. I just like, I usually use the Strathmore mixed media, but I ran out. And I like Neenah, but Neenah Classic Crest is not good with water-based products, and I like to use a lot of water things, so... But I do like Neenah with my markers. It's got a nice, smooth surface, and also you can use pencil on it, which I like. A lot of marker papers are like shiny smooth and it's hard to use pencil with them. I'm just going to test this and see if that works. Before moving on, should I use a big brush? Why not? Why not? Well, there's Bristol Smooth and Bristol Vellum. I know the Bristol Smooth I don't like. It wasn't fantastic with a lot of things that I tried, so... Just putting a bit of water on just to spread that out. I just want to make sure that's going to work before moving on to the rest of it. Kind of slipping all over the paper, so it seems like it's going to be okay. It's kind of smooth out. Oh, I'm going to need some more colour in here, but I'll have to wait for it to dry now. It's a little bit orange, so we need to add some pinks in here. Hi, Victoria. Welcome. So I really like full markers, alcohol markers. I always use Neenah Classic Crest Solar White, but I've been using the Strathmore Mixed Media paper, the one that comes in like a pad of 40, and that has been okay with marker, but you do need to be a little bit more careful with both of those with streaks. But if you're looking for no streaks, then Express It Blending Card is the best to go with marker for markers. It's smooth and shiny, and the marker just goes on without much effort. So give me back that opal. Just finish off this bit down here. I tried normal shiny sort of cardstock for markers and it did not work at all. It's got to be a balance, I think. But go back and check out some of my videos, Patty. There's heaps of videos with different products. All my original images were done on Express It Blending Card until I found out that Neenah was awesome. Don't be afraid of colors. Like, if you're using, you've been using pencils and you know you've got the dark and light sort of going down packed and you wanted to try with watercolor, just do the same thing with watercolor. I'm not using any fancy techniques or anything here. I'm just brushing over it with water. But I don't like that subtle brown. It's really like, I don't know, weird colour. We definitely need to add some pink in here. Definitely. Okay, let's let it dry. Need cloth. While it's drying, what have I done up here? I've smudged something on my page. Of course I did. She's a butterfly fairy, isn't she? Deciding what to do. Purples, pinks, purples, blues, and greens are really bright in the Tombow, so well, we could go
green gem.
Green gem, you reckon? Mm. What color hair then? Reddy brown?
Mm.
Background, we could do green, and she could have green eyes, and she could have a green outfit, and then she could have orange, yellow, orange and blue butterflies, maybe. I don't know. You know what? There's a little bit of skin in there. Just add some there. I'm processing colours. Got to do that. So if you guys don't know what colours to do, I've got a Color Wheel app, but I don't know if it's free anymore. It's just called Color Wheel. But, you could use any color wheel. Let me see if I can find my other one. Here we go. This is a color wheel. These here give you different, like, ideas on what colors go with what. So if you're doing just complementary colors, say you... Nani! What is the matter? She's just talking. Are you okay, darling? Are you okay? It's a matter. Did you want your mummy? Oh, you're such a baby. She's such a big sook, this one. Okay, so say you were going to pick red-violet for your main colour. If you were just doing a complementary colour, it's yellow-green. You could do split complementary colours, which would be blue, yellow-green, violet and red. So basically all you're doing is splitting that complementary color into the two. But there's lots of different blends that you can do. So if we decided that green was our main color, then the complementary to that would be red. If we wanted the green to be our main color in a set of four different colors, which I'm probably going to be doing, I'm going to turn this as a triangle here, a rectangle I should say. So here I could use green, purple, other square here is yellow, and red. So they're the four colours that would complement each other on the page. I know, she wanted to tell me something for sure. So that could be confusing to some people. That's why I like this app. You can pick, I want to try the four different ones. So this is telling me I could use these colors and they'll look good together. Or these colors, or these colors. Like, you just turn the wheel and it gives you an idea. Does that make sense? You might want to just use all the same or similar colors, like purple, pink, and blue. Or does that make sense? Or you might like to do just three different colors. Or just complementary. It's pretty cool, this thing. And you can also change the color level. You can just have basic colors or... It's pretty groovy, this thing. This one's just called Color Wheel. I like it. It's not free anymore, though. You have to buy it. It used to be free when I first started recommending it. No worries, Angela. Yeah, it's a good app. I'll send you a link for it later, Kenny, if you want. Okay, let me pick a color scheme then. I'm going to go yellow, orange colors, and blue, violet, and pink. I don't know. Round those. We'll do those. Okay. Yeah. So blue, green, red, orange. No, wait. Yeah. Red, violet, and yellow, greens, maybe. No, that's not right. Let me find it. Yep, that'll do. We'll just do that. Know what I'm doing? Not. Okay. Don't blame me. It's not my fault. I've got light green. I'm going to do this in the little gems here for now. Because that was Alicia's choice. I'm not going to fill out the whole area because I'm just going to use the watercolor to blend that out a little bit. And also I'll put a little bit of chartreuse, it's called, which is 133, just in there as well. I'm going to put this in her eyes. Too much. I'll zoom in a bit too so you can see it. Oh, you found a sock. Woohoo! Hi, Leslie. Hi, Christine. Welcome, peoples. Zooming in now. Where's my zoom? There's so many things on the screen today. Hi. My name is Butterfly Fairy. I need a smaller brush. That was a huge brush. I need a tiny brush. Alright, I've got a couple of different brushes here. Whoops. I'm going to go with this one. Lowell Cornell Soft Comfort Round Brush 2. And they haven't been on Amazon for a while. I don't know why. But I like them. Pretty. And that's good. I like that. Let's go with a bit of yellow. I've got light orange, 25. Let's put some in the dark areas. We can go in and put like details in with other products later, so like white pencil and white gel pen and things like that. Let's put that in the middle of that flower too. Ugh, that did not go on that lid. Doesn't want to stay on. I know, it's vibrant. They're beautiful colours. I love them. Process yellow in the rest of this section. I'm being kind of rough because I'm going to use a brush to smooth it out a bit. Give that a smooth out. Not too much water because otherwise it'll bleed out into the skin, which, look, it's still likely to anyway. I'm gonna do, I think I might do this flower. Actually, no, if I do it yellow, it's gonna blend in too much there. I'll do it pink. But a lighter pink. What have I got here? No, that's too dark. I'm using my flip chart thing here, so I know roughly what the colours are going to be like before I do them. Otherwise, you know, I've got pink 723. How original. I didn't colour the whole flower because I'm going to be using the water to blend it out a little bit. Hi, Cassie! Welcome! So I'm back again after Heather, so you're going to be sick of me. And to be honest, I have no idea what I'm going to colour. I'm a little bit conflicted. There's so many amazing images. And of course, it's been left to my choice now because we've now got all the artists represented. So, you know, who do you choose? I don't know. I don't know. I need a little bit more dark pink in there. So I'm just going back in with another layer. Had a bit of depth in there. I don't know. Is this dry yet? Not yet. Such a big decision. It is, really. Okay. This sort of orangey yellow color. Let's add this into a couple of these butterflies. Let's do it in this big one over here. Just on these edge parts. I think that's hair behind there. Need a bigger brush for that one. Let's go back to the two. Hi, Dorothy. Hi, Mish. Welcome, guys. Let's just blend that out a little bit. So it's a little bit lighter in the middle. Oops, I went over that bit, which I think was actually hair, but that's okay. It's not hair anymore. Do the same over here with this one. And then I'm going to do blue on the other butterflies. So it's a blue-violet color. Let's have a look. What have we got in the blues? Hmm. Oh, that's pretty. Deep blue. 565. We're using Tombow brush pens. Dual brush pens, and I'm making them watercolor. Yes. Go from the very edge down. And then the little circles there as well. Now I want something like aquary kind of green in there, so I'm going to use process blue for 452. I got it. What? Oh, I know, Cassie. I'm so sorry. Well, this is, I've used the Tombows on Bristol Vellum surface paper Strathmore, and also the Canson extra large watercolor paper, which is quite cheap, and they're absolutely amazing on that paper as watercolor. I haven't really tried them that much on normal paper. However, yesterday when I was doing this yesterday, I did the flower with the on this Strathmore Tantone paper, and it worked, and the eyes, and it worked really well. So I think you've just got to find the right paper, and that was without using water. So yeah, because I find they peel on a lot of paper. I know that Laura uses them a lot, so if you're interested in checking out Laura's channel, who's also a streamer for the event, then and an artist for the event, just go check her out as well, because she's done a lot of work with these. Also, I've seen her use them over the top of pencils, which is awesome. So that was the process blue. Also, there's a flower down here. Let me just grab that pink again. and fill out the flower. We use that yellow, the light orange in the middle of the other one. Let's do some watering. I'm watering the markers. I can't find my brush. Where did it go? There it is, hiding. Hi, Isabel. How are you? Oh, I've forgotten your name. YFKE. Yvette, is it? Is it Yvette? Did I get it? Is it Yvette? Please be Yvette. Did I get it right? I don't know. I think I'm really far behind, guys. I got it! Yay! That was pretty good considering I was half asleep last night. Oh, and I did not sleep well at all. Ended up with an ice pack on my back. Oh dear, it was just one of those nights. Huh? Neighbours, were they noisy, were they?
The music was going apparently until like 4 o'clock in the morning.
Well, that could be why I couldn't sleep, but I can't hear, I'm deaf, so.
I stuck my earplugs in at about 3, just after we went to bed, so.
Noisy neighbours, apparently. We are going to use some black pen later on and go and change this up a little bit, so you'll see that once I've done, but we're just going to use, I just went in a little bit into the wings with the darker blue, and now I'm coming back the other way with the lighter blue. Just going to try to blend it a little bit in the middle if I can. If I can, you know, it might not work well, but we'll give it a go. You know me, I'll give anything a go. I'll try and make everything look sexy. Yeah, baby.
Now I'm thinking Austin Powers.
What?
Now I'm thinking Austin Powers.
Austin Powers. Baby. Yeah, baby. Okay, we're going to leave that for now until it's dry. I just need to add a little bit more pink in the very depths of that flower. Give it a little bit more oomph. 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 Let's use a little bit of... Ooh, we can't use black because it goes weird in this one. Here's some black. Look, the black goes kind of like... Lamp black goes like a purpley colour. You know what? We might use warm grey because it's kind of a browny colour and I want to do the middle of the butterflies, so... What is it? Warm grey 8. I don't know. What number is that? N49. You didn't see me do the new Momo Girl book, Lulu? Love letters? Is that the one you mean? There is a video somewhere. Lost. Amongst all these streams we've done. Nope, that brush is too big. Need a little brush. The little brush I'm using is an Anna Mason one from Rosemary & Co. Hi, Jennifer! I ordered your sharpeners. They should be here tomorrow. Yeah, that's cool. That's a good color. I like that. Ah, yes, Dorothy. It's the paper. I had what's her name? Lovely artist.
Totally left my brain. She has a book.
Most artists do. She messaged me and goes, "What? How did you use the Tombow? You need to tell me." So I told her, and she's like, "Oh, I had no idea." She goes, "Mine didn't do that." But then when I said about the paper, she was like, "Oh my! I can't remember who it was." Who did Hidden Paradise? Who's Hidden Paradise? Because that's who it was. Lopez? Jennifer? Is it? I don't know. Completely lost it. It's alright, don't worry about me. I'm just crazy. Okay, we'll come back to the rest in a minute. Come back to the butterflies in a minute. We'll let them dry a bit because I don't want it to smudge. So I'm just going to put some of that light orange around there where the band is coming around her head. We need nice pink lips, I think. Pink's got to go in there. Or is it? Or should I go like a purpley red? Maybe we'll do purpley pink. We'll get rid of this one. I don't need that. Let's go with purple. 665. I say them and then I have to find them. Chris, that's it. You got it. It was Chris. She messaged me and goes, "How did you do that?" I knew one of you would know. I know, I'm crazy, sorry. I'm just going to be careful here, because I don't want to smudge it out into the skin. So I'm just going to go over the darker patches and then I'm going to use the brush to bring it into the light areas. And I'm going to use that number 2 size brush. I actually found out they did the it by accident, you know. I was doing something and I had done some swatches of the Tombows on a piece of paper and I dripped some water onto it and it went like watercolor and I was like, wow, amazing. So it was an accident, happy accident. Oh, I tried the Mikador brush pens, but they don't do it. I did try them, but they don't do it. Now that's a good color. I like that. We're going to do that in a top as well, I think. I think I need to put a tiny bit of that in these flowers too. So just popping a couple of dots around the middle section there, making it darker in the middle. Oh, that dripped. Good. Okay. Now let's go over her skin again. I'm just going to test first because I'm not sure how this will work. Cause, you know, layering and all. This is Flesh 850. Just going to do a layer of it over. Add a bit of pink. pink to the skin. It might not be enough. I might need to come in with a darker red brown to do it. Yeah, it's not really changing the colour much at all. So, we'll scratch that for now. Let's go with a red brown. I'm going to go with a red brown. I've got to find it. Redwood. Redwood. 899. Thank you. Hi, Laura. I missed you then. She's gonna get there, but I'm gonna use my yogurt lid. And I'm gonna scribble this on my yogurt lid. Like that. And my big thick brush. I'm gonna add some water. Just putting some more water on my brush. Probably too much water on my brush there. Wipe some off. I'll have it a little bit darker down here, so I'll just grab some more off my palette there and I think we're going to need to go in with some pastel and just neaten it up a little bit. Which I'm happy to do. And I think I need more pink. There's a colour called Pale Cherry, which is 912. 912. Let's just get rid of that. The brush wasn't wet enough. Yeah, I'm gonna need some pastels in here. It's less tanned than it was a minute ago, which is good. It is a bit more pink. But I still need more. It's not right. And I don't want to put too many layers on because this paper is not designed for water. But there we have some more skin done. Okay. Need a waterproof black marker. A black something. What have I got? What? Black something. Are these waterproof as well? Water and Copic proof. Cool. We're going to use the Copic multi-liner. This is a bigger one, 0.5 nib. And we're going to do our butterfly lines. I'm going to make them nice and thick. Because I definitely don't want this to smudge when I do the background. Do I? That could be, or the hair, in fact. Let's do a couple of little lines out there for the antennae. Is that the time already? Have we been an hour?
Yep.
Ah! Should we do a giveaway? Is she licking your toes?
Her claws went into my toes. Oh, poor baby, you're so cute.
Nanny's being sook. Are your feet cold, Alicia?
Yes, they are.
Huh. You know what's good about doing it this way? You can actually kind of put any pattern that you want in there. There's no mistakes. I'm very quiet today. I'm still very tired. I've still got another stream. I'm saving my energy for tonight. Conserving. Conserving. No worries, Kenny, that's okay. It does, doesn't it? It just finishes it off. I know a lot of people pop in and they probably see these half finished things and think, what is that girl doing? Hang around. There's usually, I'm going to say usually because sometimes there's not, there's usually a method to my madness. Pretty butterfly. I'm turning it upside down, sorry. Better angle on my butterfly. What time will it be my time? Okay, well, I'm on for another hour now. So, an hour from now, plus another 2 hours. So, 3 hours from now I'm on. So, whatever time it is now, add 3 hours. Because, oh, I think that's right. Let me just double check that now I've said that. I'm pretty sure that CBC is doing 2 hours. Let me check the list. No, she's doing 3 hours. My bad. So add 4 hours. 3 a.m. your time. So Heather's on for 3 hours after me. And then I'm on again for 3 hours after her. I've really confused you today, haven't I, Pat? I'm so sorry. And that's a stream I'm sort of debating on what to do. I've looked at all of the images 10 times over. I could probably get 2 images done in that time. If I did them smaller, like the last ones. Such a big decision. They're all so awesome. Now that should be yellow. So I'm just grabbing that orange again to make sure that I fill that little tiny bit out. There. And then again, normal time. That's right, Leslie. Then again, normal time tomorrow. And that'll be the last stream of February, of the Colorathon anyway. Some of the artists are keeping the specials on for the whole month of February. Some of them only last till the end of the event. So... they will be available after the event, but at the normal prices. Looking good. Eastern time? You're funny, Loretta. Eastern time, it will be 4 a.m. in the morning until Eastern 4, and I finish 7 when Coloring F comes on at 7 a.m. So I got the hours that nobody wants to do because, you know, it's like the middle of the night, early morning for everyone else in the world. And Heather also took some of that by doing her 3 hours as well, because she's amazing. I was trying to have no gaps so that for the whole time of the weekend, if you were busy or no, You could come in at any time and someone would be streaming for the Colorathon. I think it worked out well. We did one of these a few years ago. Sammy organised it and I thought that it went absolutely awesome. I really enjoyed it. I think we were all extremely tired after that one too. But I don't think we had images. I think we could just do our own images for that one. I can't remember. It was a while ago. Oh no, I think that's actually meant to be yellow. Oh well. That one's got a dodgy wing. It will be okay. It will get over it. I'll show you why in a second. Yeah, I'm doing normal time tomorrow. Abby has the last one. Oh, Loretta. Yeah, so tomorrow again at 10 a.m. Leslie for us, or for my time, which is Eastern 6 p.m. Sunday night, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3 in the afternoon for the rest of the world, and like midnight for the UK. Okay, so I stuffed this up over here and filled that out, so I'm just going to repeat it over here. Oh, she's a sook. Unless you just show me a picture of Nani. She's snoozing on her legs. I had to match it up on that side, so I've just done the same, but covered that over. This is a quite tedious work, this lineup. I don't envy these artists that do these amazing sketches and then have to go line them all out. Goodness me. I'd get hubby to do that. He's got a steady hand. Yep. That wing's shaped strange. Let me just fix that. Not exactly the same, but it's close enough. Close enough's good enough sometimes. There we go, butterflies are done. Where's my thing? Let's do a giveaway. What happened then? Yeah, I know, I missed that. I'm going to go back in with some pastel in a minute. Hi, Heather, just in time. Pat's got the boobs out already. It's funny. You're funny, guys. Oh dear me. Right up. It would have gone everywhere. I've got the 665, which was purple. I'm going to do that in her top. Yeah, I'm glad you weren't colouring or drawing or something as well. Imagine that. It would have just gone everywhere. Oh dear. I'm sure that this is one of those pieces of cloth that looks like soft and flowing over an angel or something, but we've made it bright purple, so it's all good. I'm going to use a bigger brush this time. You can join the giveaway because... Have you won something, Janine? I didn't remember you winning. You won yesterday, didn't you? I don't even remember. I'm totally lost. Was I supposed to send you something? Was that someone else's stream? Do you know how many streams I've been in over the last weekend? Anyway, of course you can join in. Because this image hasn't been given away yet. So, this particular one. If you've got one of the other images already, don't enter for that image. That's just, you know... a pain. So later on today, I'm going to be doing a giveaway for an image of Jennifer's and an image for Laura, but that will be the next stream. That will be in the 3-hour one because there's a lot more time in that one. So we'll do two then. But for this one, we'll do one of Dawn's images and we'll do the Lisa and Genovia art one. Cleaning that brush off so I can make the middle sections a little bit lighter. Because both Jen and Laura have said that they're happy to do a couple more. So I'm excited. I definitely think we need something in that, but we'll do that later when it's dry. Let's do giveaway. I'm going to do the rules somewhere here. Let's just find them. I'll just double check that, yeah, that's good. We've got 57, so 1 in 100. Only one person, one number per person. No take backs, guys. First person to call that number owns it, so if you call the same number, it has to stay. No chatting during number calling until I've drawn the number. No numbers before the words bleh, go, 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 or stop, stop, stop will be counted. Can I even read? Oh, okay, I can't speak. The number closest to the generated number without going over wins. If there isn't one, we'll draw it again. Make sure that you are on live chat. Not top chat. No top chat. Top chat. Top chat. You're right, I can't speak. Live chat. Any giveaway or promotion is in no way endorsed, administered, or sponsored, or associated with YouTube. Oh, did she? She's playing on the computer. Laura! No top chats! No top chat party. Let's go live chat. Warning, this live stream may have adult themes like boobs. So first of all, Shelley has purchased the images for Dawn Davidson, and she's going to give one of them away. So we'll do the first draw for Dawn, somebody's messaging me, yeah, for Dawn Davidson's image. I'll show you the other one. So I have both here for you to see, if I can find it, just give me a sec. Because as I said, I wasn't very organized and didn't think of that beforehand. So it's your choice of this image that I'm doing today here, or the other fairy that was for February as well. That one, the crystal one. Okay, so this one or this one, your choice for this first prize. Not yet, we're not doing, what? Sorry, I thought you were doing numbers. Sorry, Mish. My bad. Okay, so the first draw will be for one of these two images. The winner will get a choice. Okay, shall we do that first? Everybody ready? Oh, Loretta. I did a crystal tutorial on Patreon, so I'm kind of a bit like that myself. All right, let's see some readies. Peoples, come on, those people out there watching. Yeah, that's a good idea, Christine. Watch the chat. Don't listen, because there is always a lag on my videos for some reason. Because I don't know why. Because my internet's not good. It's because we're in Australia. We don't have good internet here. You can join in. You haven't won a prize from Dawn yet, so join in. Awesome, guys. Pat. Oh, jeez. Okay. go, peoples. Oh, gosh. I'm going to go a minute and a half. And then we'll give people a last minute chance to go in and do, you know, get one. Alright, we were going to do some red-brown here, weren't we? Red, red one. No, that's not the one. I'm going to use red wine and red wood, 837 and 899 for the hair. Let's go, everybody, enter. Look at these. Every time I move them, they shine and sparkle. They look so good. I have to move them somewhere else because they're getting wet. We're happy little Vegemites as bright can be. Vegemite. Oh, come on, guys. We haven't got that many. There's heaps of people watching. Come on, lurkers. Come join in. Oh-ho-ho. Is anyone's alarm going off? We haven't had any for ages. Come on. Any last minute ones? Going, going, gone. It's too late. Playing for Mish. What? For who? Mish is already up. Mitch? Who? I don't know. Okay. I'll trust you, Kenny. You know what you're doing. Hoon!
Nanny didn't like that.
She didn't like that car hooning past my house. His big V8 engine and his hotted up wheels. It's just rude. Alright, guys, that's it. Let's do it. Random generator. Ooh, random generator wheel. Should we try that? Wheel decide. Oh yeah. That looks cool. What kind of wheels can we get?
Does Helen still count?
Number wheel? Oh, that website's a pain in the butt. I'm not doing that one. Okay. I tried. Wheel decide. Didn't work. Let's use the Google. Oh, the Google one didn't come up. Oh, there it is. But we need to put 100 people in there. Okay, here we go. Sorry, guys. 22! What did you say? Kathy got 22. Kathy!
Exactly.
Let me just check. Yep, Kathy. Kathy, do I have you on Facebook? I'm sure I do. I do. Awesome. What I'll do is, I will get in contact with you and I'll get all your details and everything. I think I've got your email address even here already, so and Shelley will be sending that to you, so I'll talk to you about it. But congratulations. Yay, let's do another one because we've only got like, oh no, we can't. Yeah, we'll do another one. We'll do Lisa next. We'll use the same numbers, or does any, we'll do different numbers in case somebody else wants to join in, because if someone's come in later, they might not have put a number down, so let's do it again. Guys, it'll be a quick one though. So, go on ahead and, when you're what? When you're ready, you can go again. So everybody ready for a second one? This time we'll be doing an image, Lisa's image. So if you've already got Lisa's image, then obviously if you've got Lisa's image, then you probably won't want to enter. But if you haven't got one of Lisa's pretty Lily Faye image, which of course I'm a dumbo and didn't organize again. Let me find it again. This lovely little one from Lisa. If you haven't had one, then join in. All right, here we go. Join in, May Kay and Kim and everyone. Welcome. Join in and go. Get the numbers in. We'll do this one a quick one though. I'm still using redwood, by the way. Oh, is that a wing down there? I think it might be a wing. trying to decide what the best way to do this hair is. Another few minutes. Come on, guys. If you're lurking and you want to get a copy of Lisa's image. If you're a patron of Lisa's, this one already is free. So you might not want to enter because it's already free. I'm pretty certain it was on her website. Alrighty, getting close. I'm gonna stop it any minute now. Any second, I should say, not minute. What? You in this one, my darling.
Sure, why not?
Alright. So this was for Lisa's image. Let's go back to our random generator that we did before and let's regenerate a new number. Kenny, what? You are not in it. I already said stop. 73. Oh no, Kim went over.
Oh,
67. I'm moving down. 71. You're out of it, Kenny. You were after stop. Are you serious? Were you after an image for someone? It's Momo C. It shows you in, does it? Let me refresh. If you're in, then you won. Wait. It might be Kenny yet. Let me go to my phone chat. Hey? Oh. Night, Shalene. Okay, cool. Well, let me have a look. We must have... It's at the same time. So who's Mish? Oh! My phone's talking. Kenny won that one. I'm so lost, you. Kenny, you just contact me and let me know. That was for Lisa's. So the last one is Genovia Art. I'm not really getting much of this image colored, you know. We'll do it like 5 minutes before the end. Maybe 10 minutes before the end. Send me, because I've got it before, even on my normal chat. It's like exactly the same time. So, yeah. Okay, cool. Kenny won that one. So we'll do Genovia Art in a minute. Like, can someone, what is the time? Is it 20 to 5? Have I only got 20 minutes?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Freak out. Let's just do it now then. Alright guys, let's do it again.
So that one was for
That one, Mish, or Kenny and Mish got, whoever it was. No, no, it's fine. Let's do it again. One more. Come on, guys. Let's do it again. Who's ready? This one is for Genovia Art. The beautiful flower gear one. Nightmare. Last one, guys. Who's in? Let's say ready. Good guys, here we go for Genovia Art, let's go. Numbers please, because I only have 20 minutes. No playing for Mish, please. You guys are funny. You crack me up. I'm just going to do this little bit of part of hair and then I'll fix up some of the skin. And do a little bit of the background quickly, hopefully. I have time to do that. Alrighty. Thank you, guys. Hope you're all on live chat, please. Okay. Closest number without going over, remember, guys. So, let's redraw. Too late. Oh, Kim. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm adding Kim in. Am I adding her in? Let's... No, no, I gotta stop. Sorry, I gotta stop at stop. Otherwise, it's too... It just gets too confusing. Sorry, Kim. Sorry, Bob. You want me to put Kim and Barb in? Let's just regenerate the number and see what it is. 35. Both Kim and Barb were over it anyway. Who's closest? 35. You know what? Is it Deb? Debbie? Debbie. Doesn't matter. They were over it anyway. Debbie, congratulations. Debbie the doodler. You won. Can you please email me? And I will then send you a copy of the Genovia art picture. Yay! Congratulations after all that kerfuffle. Oh, dear me. I've got red wine. Red wine. I don't know why I like that song. I'm just going to try and hurry a little bit here. I can at least get some of this hair done. Anyone got any thoughts on what image I should do? Like, I'm thinking about using Copics because, you know, I haven't used Copics this stream-a-thon yet. So, you know, they're my jam, so I should definitely give them a go. I can't decide. Like, I've got Genovia art in my head and I don't know. Maybe Monya. I don't know. I really like Emily's house. Anyone got any thoughts? What would they like me to do? Out of all the images in the little flip through thing. Keep in mind I'm doing Sarah Richter on Monday. I'm going to do her dragon one. Which is actually not technically a February image, but she has got a special on it at the moment in her store for February, so I thought I would do that. It looks like Heather's giving me a little bit of grace, so if I do go over slightly, it's okay. Because she's awesome. But I've still got 3 hours later on anyway, so it's alright. Hi, Joanna. Christine, you reckon? We've had a few do Laura already. Who's here? Is Sammy here? Where is Sammy? I'm not going too much over. I have to prepare, what is it? Beef, sweet beef and soy something noodles tonight, don't I? From my HelloFresh box. Oh, bit too much water. No, I blurred it out. I didn't want to do that. My bad. I wanted to try and keep a little bit of texture in there, but plopping that on there just got rid of that texture, didn't it? There's still people who are lined up to do those, Abby. All of the artists are represented, so there's still more people streaming. We've still got another day to go, so. I think Colouring F is doing Christine Caran. So I probably won't do it because she's only got one image. If she had more than one image, I might have, you know, done one. I don't want to do the same image as everyone else. Like, we want to try and keep them different. If we can. But I think Emily's doing her house, so. How's that look? Kind of messy. I'm definitely going to need to come in with a pencil with that. White pencil's brilliant for everything. use our palette pastels quickly to fix up some skin. I've just got the Jane Davenport palette pastels, the birthday suit ones. Again. What? I could do one of Monya's. I really loved Monya's background. That was amazing. She did have a bit of technical issues with the with her live, but she managed to do it as a premiere video, which was really good. So go check out Monya's, her night sky. You know what? I should do a I tried to follow video and try to follow Monya's video. How do you reckon I would go? I think I'd be alright. I say that now. But I probably wouldn't. Ah, who knows? Who knows? I just use my desk mat to wipe off my brush. I probably shouldn't do that. What's wrong? Jane Davenport birthday suit palette pastels. And I'm using a bit of bling and a bit of glorious. I used a bit of Pinky Promise in her cheeks. I love the names. Pinky Promise. Adding a bit of pink back in because that was really, really, really orange coloured. It happens. But, these are awesome for covering up any mess that you make. The secret to getting smooth, flawless skin. Cover it up. Oh, a little bit of bay under the nose. Under the lip. I love Jane Davenport. She is glorious. I love her. Her products are awesome too. I've tried to use the palette pastels just by themselves, but they weren't that fantastic. They're better for cover up and over the top of other things. I think that skin's a lot smoother. I think we need a little bit more of that Pinky Promise in that cheek there. Just fade it out a bit. Maybe put a little bit in the eyelid area. There we're going up for 5 minutes. 5 minutes and all's well. Let's do some white. The tip of the nose. Actually, it's not white. It's called Whisper. I'm just going to whisper on the highlights. Just going to whisper them on there. Just a whisper. Ooh, eyeshadow. Colour a picture with eyeshadow. That's a weird challenge. It's bad enough trying to do it with palette pastels. I just don't think that's going to work. I've got a little bit of a glow. And I'm just going to do under... in the waterline area. Okay. I'm going to need a bigger brush to do this lower bit. I need a bigger boat. glorious. Don't worry, it's clean, it's just stained. These are the soft tools for the palette pastels. I like them. For the pan pastels, I should say. Is that what I said? Just smoothing out that weird color that we ended up with. It kind of went green, actually. It's sort of hard to explain, and I mean, you can't really see it under the camera, but it did go a weird color. We'll just cover that up with a bit of glorious. Yeah, I'm assuming it's going to be quiet for the later ones. That's okay. That is okay. I don't know, I think we'd be pleasantly surprised. We've had so many people, it's been amazing. I think my time's up. I'm going to use white, and I'm just going to go in and put in some white pencil flicks. In the hair, to add some detail in there, especially in that smudged out bit that I did before. Give it some shininess, even it out a little bit. I'm also going to use some white gel pen in there too. Same colours in her eyebrows as in her hair. I had to finish off the face for some reason. I feel like I'm not finished if I haven't finished off the face. I won't be adding water to these either. Let's grab that black Copic multi-liner again. Do those eyelashes. Couple of down ones. Well, I hope I've done Dawn's image justice. Well, what I've done anyway. Looking in that direction, so I'll just do her lashes in that direction. How's she looking? Good. Yeah. Night, guys. You can't wait to play with them. And all I was going to do in the background was use that those greens, just scribble them around like this. And drop some water on them. And then do the wings transparent. So just do a line of white gel pen around them. That was it. That's all I was going to do. So that won't take me very long at all. So what I'll do is I'll get dinner done and, I smudged the hair. That's going to annoy me. I'm going to figure out how to get around the hair idea. Not go too close to it would probably be the best idea. And not use too much water. And, well, that's her arm. Guys, I missed her arm. We'll do that too. Alright, well, thank you so much, guys. All pop over and check out the lovely Heather now, who's colouring in, Colour and Chicks. Colour and Chickies. And I'll see you again in a couple of hours. Well, actually, a few hours. 3 hours. Huh? Well, she's going to have to move because we're going to cook dinner. Bye, guys. Enjoy. I will see you later on. Bye.